the follicles that are moving through the ovary to produce the follicles that we're going to use to produce the eggs, you can think of it being in basically three compartments. A storage phase, which you've had all your life, and which is slowly seeding in into the process in a steady state. Think of it like a drip, drip, drip kind of a thing. Then there are a pool of follicles that are on deck, that are really in the active training process of getting ready for the next cycle. And you can think of those as waves coming in into the beach, and you can see those waves, several courses of them, as you stand on the shore of the beach. And so in that pool, there probably are the follicles that are going to represent the next 3 or 4 months of cycles. And then lastly, those that are actively involved in the current cycle. Now, as the follicles move through that process, think of the waves getting closer and closer to the shore, they become more and more responsive to the stimulating hormones. And so the ovulation induction hormones, the gonadotropins that we give you, the fertility hormones that we give you in this cycle, are not just acting on the follicles that are going to grow and produce an egg in this cycle, but to some degree are acting on the earlier follicles as well. That wave, which is building up, all those waves which are building up under the influence of these fertility medications, if you continue that pressure, continue that wind into the next cycle, you have a chance of bringing more to the table instead of letting it die down and starting all over again after several months. And that's the theoretical basis for why we did this study.